Today is April 21st. I'm Sami. This is going to be just a quick energy update. I haven't done a video in quite a while. I wanted to do one for the new moon, but the energy was way too intense. So let's talk about that firstly. The new moon happened on the 11th and 12th of April in Aries. And the sun was still in Aries at that point. So we got a really big energy boost. And like a new beginning, the need to take initiative on things, anything that you had been wanting to start, new things came about, new ideas, new projects, that sort of thing. That happened over last weekend, the 11th and 12th. And then this past weekend, actually, what's today? Sunday evening into Monday the 19th, and then even yesterday the 20th, the energy on the Schumann was off the charts. It was like a whiteout the whole day of the 19th practically, and then even on the 20th it was a lot of energy and starting to calm down from there. So a few things about the energy. Now we can feel things ramping up, a new beginning happening. And this is because we are moving into a more fully fourth dimension. We're moving higher, more directly, I feel like saying, into the fourth dimension now. So the veil is thinning. My mediumship abilities have been coming and going since the new moon. Different psychic, just the clear cognizance, just knowing things has increased. Psychic attacks. You may have noticed from the Schumann that energy was so crazy. Headaches, heart palpitations, high level anxiety, not being able to sleep, feeling just your body may have felt tired, but your mind, and even a weird sense of anxiety, just energy, like you may have felt like you wanted to sleep, it was time to sleep, why can't I sleep? But there's something keeping you up. And there was so much energy on the planet. So aside from that, there was a solar flare to Mars facing a few days ago, and we just had another one. I haven't checked into it. I just know there was another big flare, so I'm not sure if it's Earth facing or if it was facing another planet, but I know the last one was facing Mars. And there's just a lot going on right now on the planet. So as we move higher into the fourth dimension, of course those here on the planet, the dark or reptilian, Draco, Cabal, whatever you want to call them, are desperate and gonna be kicking it up a notch and gonna just be reaching and grabbing for anything they can because they know we're moving higher. So they want to prevent that in any way possible, and they're doing that. They're gonna want to lower your vibration in any way possible. I've had dreams about satellites and Elon Musk, so that is going to be used for vibration purposes. If you want to look into that stuff. So the main thing about this energy is when the veil thins, it's better because you're more aware of the spiritual world. But that can be good and bad. So just be aware of that. Psychic attacks are more probable, as well as being more easily connected to your spirit guides, your angels, source, and your higher self and your knowingness. Another thing that's been happening is out of body experiences. So this is just another aspect of the veil thinning, but this is what we're going to be experiencing more of as the planet moves through this new higher dimensional space. So I will just be walking around my house and doing tasks, daily things, and I'm just realizing my body is doing things, making moves, but I'm above my body, just realizing, oh, I'm in a body. I have this human body. So it's just more of an awareness in that moment. So that can help us with living in the moment, you know, and just recognizing, oh man, when you take a step back in that way, I wasn't trying to do that. It was just happening, and it's been happening. So I don't feel like this is going to go back now. I think we're just gonna continually move more and more into 4D. We're still gonna see the 3D grasping for whatever they can. There's still gonna be naysayers and people of lower frequency and density around us who are spitting that narrative and whatever. You can choose to ignore it. The more you live in 4D and 5D, the less you'll have to deal with that. So if you haven't figured out a way to exit the matrix, I'm still trying to find my way to exit the matrix. That's something we all should be doing. So many of you own your own businesses and you're able to make your own money and not have to worry about working for anyone or the government or anything like that. If you own your own property outside of the city, or you can grow your own food, that sort of sustainability is what we want to be moving towards. Family is another thing. You may have noticed issues with family, triggers coming up, because there's something about Aries energy. It is renewing, but when you get a burst of energy like that, sometimes it can be aggressive. And we're just dealing with so much right now. So be aware. Dream state has been heightened. You're doing a lot of work in your dreams. If you wake up and you feel like you barely got any sleep, you've been doing a lot in dream state. Okay, fighting battles, all kind of things are happening in the spiritual realm right now. And we're going to start to see more and more of it here as the veil thins. So keep in mind, you want to protect yourself daily, spiritually. You can do that by taking two minutes to yourself in the morning. What I like to do is, after grounding and bringing in more light through my head, down to my toes, and once I release any negative thoughts, or just start really being consumed by my gratefulness, my appreciation for the chance to be on the planet right now and witness this whole thing. You know, billions of people, billions of souls, probably trillions of souls wanted to be here right now. And that is one of the main reasons why we have so many people here on the planet. So we have a front row seat. We play a part in this. And so it's very important that we don't get upset, we don't get depressed, we don't let these things weigh us down. Right now we're being given the opportunity from the universe to kind of recharge. Okay, so as you do this in the morning, as you go through your appreciation rant or chant or whatever you do in your mind about your car, your kids, your health, your house, your job, your money in stocks, your flowers outside, your creativity, whatever it is that you love, what you're passionate about and what you're grateful for, that sort of energy is what's gonna bring in the 4D faster. It's what's gonna keep you higher, and it keeps your body whole and protected, okay, when you're in that higher vibration. Because you are of higher vibration, though, and the veil is thinner, lower density beings may be more attracted to you. So that's where the spiritual attacks come in. So as you're doing this in the morning, I know I'm going off on random tangents, but just have to say it as it comes up. So after you're in that place and you're filled with the light and you've grounded, you've sent down your grounding cord into the planet, and you said thank you to Gaia and thank you to Source, and you're just really ready to go, and you tell Spirit, I'm ready for whatever comes next. I'm ready to play my role in this. I'm grateful for the chance to do so. Thank you so much. Then you wanna imaginarily, in the astral, in the spirit realm, zip up your energy all the way from the ground, all the way up, and zip it up. Okay? This goes for empaths. If you're highly affected by other people's energy, if you enter a room and you feel like crap all of a sudden and you don't understand, or you can sense people's negativity, you might be an empath. So that's a great exercise or quick meditation in the morning for anyone to do to protect your energy, and for empaths as well, to protect your emotional and spiritual body. But when you zip it up, zip, 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 all of that good light stays inside and will reflect away, deflect negativity, psychic attacks. And so these attacks are happening in sleep state too. So be aware. Crazy dreams have been happening. We do have this boost of energy, so use it wisely. Use it for manifesting the world that you want. We're here in Taurus now with the Sun, Venus, Mercury, Uranus. There's a few more, but it's a powerful stellium here in Taurus. I think until the 31st. And then even before that, during that time, on the 26th, we have a full moon in Scorpio this week. So, you know, Scorpio is about the hidden and the darker and the occult and the emotional and the sensitive. And really feeling things out and investigating, you know, questioning things. And very sensual. And so is Taurus. So you might feel a higher sense of sensuality this week with the full moon. You may already be feeling that with Venus and Taurus. Taurus is about feeling. What is the energy around you in your environment? So how does it feel? How does it look? How does it sound? How does it taste? Taurus loves those kinds of comforts. So that's where Mercury is as well as Venus and the Sun. So we have a lot of energy here in Taurus, which is about money, materialism, breakthroughs with money, breakthroughs in your job, breakthroughs in love, reaching new levels in love, and also beauty. So spending more time in nature, spending more time painting, spending time sewing clothes or buying new clothes or whatever it is that you love. What is beauty to you? Going to the ocean, whatever it is for you, this is a great time to really recharge in those aspects. And that's what the universe is giving us now, this chance. After the end of March, I was exhausted. I don't even know how I made that video on the 1st of April. I didn't want to make a video. I didn't want to leave my house. I didn't want to do anything because I was just so weighed down by the negativity and the media. And I don't watch the news and that kind of stuff, but you know, I check on my phone different headlines and check to see what's going on in the world just to be aware. And I was so weighed down by that. And I feel like a lot of people were, and I was losing hope. And I was thinking, why did I come here? Like, this is terrible. And I lost sight for a moment of my job here and how grateful I really am and how appreciative I really am. So that's part of those psychic attacks. It's part of the 3D in the dark projecting that they're winning and all this stuff that isn't true. And it worked for a time. So now I feel like after moving into this space now with the new moon in Aries, that brought all that new energy, a new beginning, and now we have this space of love and beauty and comforts and money and value. What do you value? What do you want to move towards in your life? What do you want to create? This is a time to recharge before moving forward into another difficult time. So I feel that the universe, God, source, creator, whatever you want to call that energy of the creator, is giving us this chance now to soak it all in and move towards the place that will be best for us for the future, because it's going to get bumpier. It's going to get harder this summer. Jupiter moves into Pisces soon. And that could be good and that could be bad. So this energy is just, it's not coming to a head yet. We're going to be dealing with the dark. We're going to be dealing as they slip away. They're fighting tooth and nail. They do not want to give up this planet. So it's going to take time. It's going to take a few more years of this, and it's going to get harder and worse, and we're going to witness war and death and pain. We just have to keep this light, keep holding this light, recharge your energy now when you're given this chance for beauty and love and value. What do you value? I love planting flowers. It makes me happy. The vibrant colors makes me feel good to go out in my flower garden in the morning and just witness creation. What does that for you? I will be doing a tarot video soon. All signs. I felt for a while I shouldn't do a video because I felt that YT was suppressing them or not notifying people of them because the views had gone way down. So if there's any specific questions you have, anything you want me to talk about, any specific kind of tarot video you'd like to see, anything like that, all signs for money, all signs for love, I would love to do those kinds of things, but it's just very time consuming. And I don't really make any money doing it, so other things just have to come first. I love it and it's fun, but then editing, you know, just takes a long time. So if I could do that full time, that would be awesome. But, you know, got the cheerings, got their schoolwork, and worrying about all kind of things. So I hope you enjoy this time. Let me know what you want to see. Please like and subscribe. Soak in this time. Be aware of your surroundings. Enjoy those moments when you get that out-of-body experience. When you're getting those messages from your higher self or whatever, as I have been, reach out to those people and tell them. Even if you look crazy. Even if you think you're gonna seem like a crazy person, because people need that. And most of the time, your guides aren't gonna push you to say something if it isn't needed. You know, they don't want you to look crazy. And that person needs healing, or that person needs love, or just someone to talk to, or that message that you have to tell them. So use your intuition, use your guidance system. Remember that you are divine. Remember the little moments during the day as you go through that this is your amazing body. Treat it right. It gives you life. It gives you meaning for now in order to live out your purpose and path for humanity. And think about the huge work that we're doing. We're doing it big time. I'm proud of you. I love you. Humanity is gonna skyrocket. And not everybody wants to go. Not everyone chooses to go this lifetime, but a lot of us will be going. So I look forward to that. I am grateful to serve beside you, and I hope that you have a great day. See you in the next video.